dinner, $2.95. Happy New Year, everyone. First, a superhero takes down the smut peddlers of Gotham in bat pussy. Then, in the post-apocalypse, sex negatives gather to watch sex shows at Cafe Flesh. Finally, four buxom girls sell lingerie to raise money in Bikini Car Wash Company 2.
You don't even know how to eat somebody. You don't even know how to do it. You wouldn't know how if you was doing your grandmother.
Welcome back to Junk Food Dinner. The first movie we're going to be doing on our Happy New Year porno-themed episode is Bat Pussy from 1973. This is a movie that I first heard about on the Movies About Girls podcast. If you've never listened to it, it's a great movie and goofy themed show. They did this back in 2010, on January 2nd. It was just about 6 years ago they did this, and I was introduced to it. Had never heard about it before, and I'd always wanted to do it on the podcast because it's like such a great, I don't know, it's such a weird entry into the world of cinema. But I never wanted to do it because the Movies About Girls podcast did it so well. But I thought as we got around to Happy New Year and trying to pick out some of the weirdest and most interesting porno movies that we could think of, this one definitely comes to the top of my list. So this is one, there's not a lot known about this movie. Nobody involved with it has ever been identified. And from what I understand, how this movie came to surface in recent years is the people at Something Weird Video. They put this out on DVD. And from what I understand, how they acquired it is they, you know, Mike Vraney and, you know, Frank Henenlotter and these guys, they would go around to all these like drive-ins and exploitation houses. And, you know, just, if they were still even standing, they'd just go in the back rooms and round up any exploitation reels they could and try to salvage these movies. So apparently this one came from a drive-in movie theater in Tennessee, and it was an abandoned one, or it had gone out of business, but they found this. There's no credits. There's nothing to go along with it. So nobody knows who really made this. They placed it around 1973. To call it a porno is
is an insult to pornography.
Yeah, it's so, let me give you the setup. This is we start off with two. First of all, this is how the movie started. There's no intro, there's no credits or anything. We just get two already nude hillbillies in a room. And one, the dude whose name is Buddy, who we later find out, and the woman's name, who is Sam. Buddy's reading a copy of Screw magazine. We just jump in right into their conversation. Let me give you a taste of that.
Come on and go to bed, and I'll show you.
Fantastic. Hey, look what they're doing right there, huh?
Yes, I'll show you.
Would you really do that?
Yeah, come on and go to bed. You don't
want to
do that. When you come home,
you
just sit there and read a magazine.
I really wouldn't want to submit you anything like that. You understand that?
So, if you get the picture, we've got two fucking old. I mean, how old would you put these people? Like in their 40s, 50s?
Yeah, 40s or 50s.
Yeah, not particularly attractive either one of them, and clearly a little drunk, to say the least. So they kind of go back and forth. They start, she starts performing oral sex on his limp penis. I'll give you a little taste of that. see if you can catch the crew person belch in the background on this one.
Oh, that's beautiful, baby. That's what the picture in the magazine was. Oh, that's, I just don't know what to do now. I just, it's beautiful.
So this is what we're doing.
Yeah. It becomes clear at that point that it's not just the on-screen performers who are completely drunk.
Right, absolutely. Everybody involved with this quote-unquote movie totally drunk. So, you know, as the title is Bat Pussy, you would think, okay, this is supposed to be Batman themed, I'm guessing. And that's when we cut away from Buddy and Sam to this.
Meanwhile, at Bat Pussy's secret warehouse hideout, Dora Dildo, alias the Mighty Bat Pussy, is patiently waiting for her super senses to tell her that a crime is about to be committed. She can always tell when her twat begins to twitch.
So
I like the dramatic line reading there.
Yeah. So this is where they factor in the Batman angle. This is a woman in a closet somewhere with a literally drawn with marker sign that says Bat Pussy Cave. She's in some like nightgown. She gets pissed because she thinks that somebody's making a porno movie in Gotham City. I mean, listen to this fucking hillbilly.
God, Bill, I feel like a crime is about to be committed.
You know,
my secret twat tells me somebody's about to shoot a foot movie in my holy Gotham City.
So yeah, that's your bat. That's your protagonist. So anyway, my theory is that this movie was edited in camera because I think they literally filmed that first part with Buddy and Sam. They drove over to this warehouse, wherever this was, filmed this scene, came back to the hotel or wherever they were, and Buddy and Sam had gotten a little more drunk and a lot more hostile. They have gone from kind of playful antagonization of each other while attempting sloppily to have oral sex with one another. Now they have gotten kind of mean-spirited and are... trading barbs back and forth, such as this.
Say, come on, you motherfucker, get up here.
Won't you fuck me, huh?
Why don't you kiss my ass? My money-making ass.
That's a money-making motherfucker, all right.
Let me tell you.
But you ain't got pussy, babe. You ain't got pussy. Oh, you got some goddamn wash tub there.
My pussy in a wash tub.
Look at that pussy. You call that a money-making motherfucker?
Sure is.
You call that a money-making son of a bitch?
Yeah, right, it's a money-making.
I'll tell you what, babe, but one motherfucker around, they'll suck that son of a bitch, and it's me. But I will suck that motherfucker, see?
Romance. It's alive and well. Yeah. So these hillbillies bicker back and forth, all the while trying to, like I said, sloppily insert digits into vaginas and perform fellatio on flaccid penises. They never, this dude Buddy never gets an erection this entire movie. So I don't know if we could, like I said, really classify it as porn, although there is oral sex. But to me, this has a lot less to do with typical porno movies, and this really feels more like in the world of like early John Waters stuff. Like, I bet John Waters sees this movie and is like, oh my god, I wish I had made this. It, like, these characters are so fucking batshit crazy, pun intended, that I mean, they're so drunk, you instantly wonder, like, how the fuck this movie got made, how many people were involved. Because, you know, part of me at first was like, well, maybe it's just like three people, like the people on screen are the actual people making this movie. But no, at parts, the sound drops out and you can see somebody behind the camera basically giving them instructions on what to do. And they just very sloppily put this mute over it. But yeah, it's fucking terrible. I can't imagine going to a drive-in movie theater in 1973 and hoping to see a good fucking stroke pick and, you know, rub one out in my car. And this comes on. Like, who's able to masturbate to this? How did somebody make prints of this and distribute it across the country? It is baffling. So yeah, lots of bickering back and forth. I have so many clips. I'm not going to play them all, but they're so good. But to wrap the quote unquote plot up, you get a Bat Pussy breaks in. And to the woman who plays Bat Pussy's credit, she actually tries to give it, you know, try to spice this up a little bit. She's really performing here, trying to make it as sexy as possible, but not being helped by Buddy and Sam. They bicker. At one point, Buddy falls off the bed and lands ass first on Bat Pussy's head, which I thought was amusing.
And then he's like, oh my.
And once again, they look at the director like, what do we do now?
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, and then the audio drops back out while the director talks to them.
Yeah. Oh, I forgot to mention the longest part of disgusting hillbilly bickering is when Bat Pussy arrives to the hotel where Buddy and Sam are. She does so by riding along on one of those like balls, those like hopping balls that you would ride on as a kid, to like weird, like the weird, like psychedelic surf riff, only stopping in the park to like beat up some guys who are trying to mug some lady. So, that is like the only safe for work part of this movie. Then it's right back to Buddy and Sam with romantic dialogue such as this.
That's the problem right there. Look at that big old pussy right there. That's the biggest goddamn pussy I've ever seen.
Well, my lawyer's not complaining.
Lawyer.
That's the biggest pussy.
That's why you don't have to pay no child support, because I've been going to pay for my lawyer.
Hey, I'm by God glad to hear that, because if a fucking kid come out of that goddamn pussy right there, it'd have to be a fucking monster.
You can't write dialogue like that.
Yeah.
Even Quentin Tarantino can't write dialogue like that.
And you know, if you were watching this, you almost would feel bad for Sam, because like this Buddy guy's just throwing all these horrible insults. But she's totally game. She's throwing jabs right back at him. She's a formidable opponent. So it's a weird dynamic. I would burn copies of this and watch it with friends at like parties and stuff and like really creep people out. But at the same time, like it was, everybody had a different reaction to it, and it's a lot of fun. We had a theory that if you could produce like a avant-garde, like off-Broadway play of this, and it would be like the Toast of like New York, if played correctly. It's just, you have to see it to believe it. You know, where else are you going to get pondering life's great questions such as,
hey, is you going to suck the motherfucker? Or is you gonna forget it? Now what are you gonna do?
And lastly, I think this line sums up this movie perfectly and so succinctly. This is from Sam.
How does it feel? How does it feel?
Terrible.
So yeah, that's Bat Pussy. It's a weird, crazy, homemade porno movie with a bunch of like straight hillbillies. I would love to see a documentary like trying to hunt down these people if they're still alive and interview them now. Someone needs to do that, because this movie is a mystery. It's a true weird artifact from the world of cult film, and don't go into it thinking it's ironic or erotic, because it's on our porno episode. It is anything but it is too weird to not see. So I'm glad I kind of forced you guys to watch it this week, but I'm dying to know what you guys thought about Bat Pussy.
Yeah, this was definitely a very weird one. I hadn't seen this before, had not even really heard of it before. So I was pretty glad we got a chance to watch this. You know, there are a number of things about this that are interesting. Actually, the first thing that I noticed in this is in the opening shot, you get a shot of Screw Magazine, the Al Goldstein magazine, which is pretty cool. And maybe that's some kind of clue to the people behind this, or maybe just Screw Magazine was showing up in pornos all the time back then.
Probably.
You know, we'll never know.
No, I did like that. This whole thing had a whole budget of $100, and $250 of that went to that Screw Magazine.
Yeah,
the rest
sure
went to booze. And
yeah, it's such a shame that there are no credits at all on this. And I wonder if they were cut for the Something Weird release, or if they just had no credits when they found this film at whatever drive-in it was sitting in.
Yeah.
But it does have like a fun little intro that was probably like a stock intro for this Dragon Art Theater.
Yeah.
Where this old dude comes on, probably the proprietor of this theater, explaining to you in detail repeatedly that this is an adult film. And if you don't know what an adult film is, you can leave the theater now. Which, you know, that's a fun little piece of history there to include.
When you Google the Dragon Art Theater, there's a post that shows up saying that it is in Columbus, Ohio. So I don't know if that's some new Dragon Art Theater or what that's in reference to, but like I just found like a little Facebook page for it that just says the Dragon Art Theater, Columbus, Ohio, and like no other information. So yeah, this is possibly from Columbus. This could be Blake Sells' ancestors or something.
Yeah, this could be Blake Sells' inception on film. Although the guy never gets hard, so maybe not.
Yeah.
Yeah, man, like this is such a weird thing. And it's not just the sexual performances in this, or quote unquote performances, that are amazing. The production itself is also pretty crazy. Like you know, like we said, you can hear the camera guy burping in the background. But just like the camera work is all over the place. Like it just kind of drifts in and out. Like somebody is just stumbling around the room. There, like you said, it appears like it was edited in camera because every time they cut the scene, like it starts off with them like not prepared at all. And then they kind of like briefly get their shit together and then start the scene. And the audio too is like really weird. It's like this echo chamber. I'm not sure how they captured the audio for this, but it feels like they had a microphone like 50 feet away from the action. And it was just like a really echoey room because it's really bizarre. It almost makes you feel like you're smoking some heavy doobies while you watch this, even if you're not. Such a weird movie. Your pussy. Yeah, there it is. Yeah, so many great moments. Like you said, the guy can't get hard for the whole thing. And at one point, he gets frustrated enough, I think, to orient himself into a 69 position where you can't see like his crotch at all for a while. Like, I think that was his strategy. And it's kind of fun to watch this and put yourself in the mind of this guy who's just desperately trying to get hard for 50 minutes or however long this thing is. And just he just can't do it, man. It's pretty amazing.
He's got the whiskey dick.
Yeah, he's got the whiskey dick for sure. Which, yeah, it's I almost felt like this was a real couple. Because so many of these lines, like I said, I don't think you could write. You know, you can write things like "bat pussy can suck a dick," which they say like 100 times in this. But those lines about her like fighting about her lawyer, and some stuff in this just seems like really specific, where she's like, "I've been married to you for 11 years, and you've had this fucking problem, you know, all 11 years or whatever." And yeah. I don't know. So I would love to know the backstory of this. Like, you, well, it's
I think,
quite a mystery.
I think a lot of it is improvised and not real, because this line in particular seems a bit suspicious.
I'll tell you what, I'm going to take my secretary tomorrow, and I'm going to fuck her right in my ass.
That dude does not have a secretary.
Yeah, that's a good point. Yeah. That is a good point. You know, and of all the things in this, yeah, I think it's funny that this guy gets so irate, and that the Sam character, his wife or whatever it's supposed to be in this, is right there toe to toe with him. She's knocking him down, you know, probably twice as much as he's knocking her down. But the woman in this who didn't appear to be game to me was Bat Pussy herself. I don't know if you guys got the feeling, but towards the end, it looked like she was legitimately upset by the proceedings and had to leave the set.
Yeah. Well, like I said, she comes in raring to go. She, like I said, she brings some energy when she first comes in, but
things seem to sour. Oh, yeah. I'm not sure that she got upset that she couldn't get any of that whiskey dick or what happened. Maybe she didn't want to have that guy's ass in her face, but she hightails it out of there pretty quickly.
Yeah, he does fall completely on her head. And for a while at the end, the other lady, Sam, right?
Yeah.
She's like trying to put this dildo in Bat Pussy in her vagina. And it's just not going, and she's trying and trying, and it's just not going, and she's trying and trying, and it's just not going. So I would imagine that might have upset Bat Pussy to some degree as well.
Yeah, sounds like a bad time for everybody.
Yeah, it's a pretty rough watch. You know, to be honest, it's one of those things where I'm glad that I saw this. I'm not sure that I need to rewatch it again, although I would love to see that documentary about how it was made, but... Yeah, overall, it's kind of like stumbling upon like some dirty Polaroid pictures of like your friend's parents, where it's like,
Grandpa. Oh
man, I really don't want to see this, but I guess it's kind of weird and funny and interesting that I did see this. But yeah, what a singular experience this movie is.
Yeah, totally. This is a singular movie. Well, first of all, I should say that I'm very upset. Letterboxd won't let me log this movie because it apparently has some sort of fascist dictatorship and isn't down with adult movies. So that bums me out. And it's also a shame because I would like to give this movie 5 stars on Letterboxd because this is one of the best things I've ever seen in my life. Although I guess it's not so much one of the best things I've ever seen because I wish I could unsee it. But it's like one of the best things I've ever known about, I guess. Yeah. There's a very long part at one point where the guy is trying to tell Sam that he wouldn't have a problem with fucking her on her ass because it'd be like fucking a dude in his ass, and he doesn't care either way what goes on.
I have that.
You'd rather fuck man than me?
Hey, baby. Let me tell you something. You turn your ass over, If I'm fucking you in the ass, it don't make no difference whether it's you or a man, because it don't make goddamn me, because I'm going to get me some good ass.
She.
Now.
Which, yeah, Sam's catchphrase is, she.
It's pretty progressive, you know, for 1973.
Yeah, I couldn't tell if this was like some weird, bizarre thing, or if it was like just, if these were people who were so into, so free that they were just like pretty chill with this, like, with this idea that, like, you know, it could be a man or a woman, don't matter to me. I'm a very progressive Southern gentleman in 1973, apparently.
Yeah, Buddy really strikes me as a real progressive Southern gentleman.
Well, I mean, who knows? It's either that or he just accidentally
drunk racist. That's what I'm seeing.
Well, it could be that, but I mean, I guess it's either he's a very progressive Southern gentleman, or he just accidentally came out of the closet in a porno movie. It's one of the two.
I think that's probably what happened.
It could be. I love the scenes when the audio drops. Like, there's this part where the audio drops, but right beforehand, Buddy says, "Do what?" and looks right at the screen. Which I like a lot. I like, "Do what?" That's funny. When Sam's talking about how she fucks his lawyer, like, that's weird, because it's like, how well do you, like, why does he just have a lawyer at all times? Like,
right.
I think we played a bit of this, but for a long time, Buddy goes on about how Sam's pussy's like really fat. It's like, why is this happening? And then, yeah, like, they spend so much time and energy trying to get that dildo to go into Bat Pussy, and it just doesn't work. And then, like, the movie just kind of ends. Like, Bat Pussy just gets up and grabs her cape, and then it's over. Like,
oh yeah.
It's real sudden.
Just as quickly as it started, it's done.
Yeah, it's real wild. There's no cum shot or anything, which is very bizarre for, I guess, an adult movie.
I like this dialogue here where Sam and Buddy are talking about their horoscopes.
Look, I read my horoscope today, buddy.
What did it say? Fuck you.
My horoscope said I'm supposed to fuck you.
Really?
In the nose.
Yeah.
In the ear.
Wouldn't it be great to pick up a newspaper and your horoscope just says fuck you?
Yeah.
Yeah, man. This almost seems like it's more like a student educational film to scare children off the dangers of alcohol. Like, it's some whiskey reefer madness, you know? More so than a porno.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's pretty
wild. If you get drunk, you're gonna end up like this.
Could be. Like, they should definitely show this to 14-year-olds. Like, don't drink, don't have sex. If you do, this is what it's like. Or at least
this is your future.
Yeah. Or at least, like, this could definitely turn kids off from sexting, right? Like, don't sext, or they're going to find your stupid sexts in the future and put them out. And then people with podcasts are going to be making fun of your sex.
Right.
Yeah. It's weird. Like, it seems like there had to have been a script or something for this, because these people are saying, like, very specific things. Either that, or, like, Buddy and Sam are, like, really witty and funny, because, like, they say these, like, very unique, like, somewhat witty but, like, kind of stupid things. Like, it's very weird.
Very stupid.
Yeah, but they're not, like, if somebody told you, hey, drink a bunch of booze and then say a bunch of stupid shit, like, never in a million years would you come up with the stuff that these people are saying. So
there's a lot of men that like to,
oh, you're fucking ass.
There's this part where Buddy starts talking about how,
but it's so baffling. Go ahead.
Oh, Buddy at one point starts talking about how he's going to stick his tongue so far into Sam's vagina that it's going to come out her butthole. And it's
like, I've sucked them titties for the last fucking time. I've been sucking them motherfuckers for the last 9 years, and I ain't gonna suck them no more. I ain't gonna suck the pussy no more. Yeah, every time I run my tongue up your pussy, it comes out your asshole. Now, what the fucking deal is that?
What the fucking deal is that?
Yeah.
Like, I just don't understand, like, what these people are saying half the time, because, like, they'll say something really mean and then, like, they'll follow it up with a question like that. Like, like, they legit want answers.
Yeah.
Because he'll say it, like, multiple times. Like, he'll say, you know, like, I've been rubbing your titties for 9 years. What the fuck is up with that? And he'll say it, like, over and over again. Like, he legit wants an answer.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's so bizarre to like see this couple who are in the throes of lovemaking be so hostile to each other. It's just the weirdest thing. It's I don't know if you guys ever saw that Shut Up Little Man.
Yeah.
Kind of reminds me of that in a way.
Right.
You really pissed me off now, so I'm going to touch. How long have I been married to you? 11 years?
Yeah. And you always get some other goddamn broad. You like her better than I am. I'm getting a divorce tomorrow. My lawyer's better than you are.
When I get through sucking your pussy and my tongue comes up through your goddamn mouth, there, I want you to holler help.
Jesus Christ.
Yeah, I love it.
I think one of my favorite parts is towards the beginning where he just keeps saying, "Oh, you're attractive." He just keeps heckling her with that. It's really great. Oh, you're attractive.
Yeah, this is wild. I love this movie. I don't think I ever want to watch it again because it's gross as fuck.
It is gross. I mean, there's a scene where Buddy's just mashing his hand into her vagina.
Yeah.
And it's like a close-up, and it's just like, stop it, dude. What is wrong with you?
And he's got the hand of like an oil mechanic. Like, it's like all black around the fingernails and like dirty and stuff. Like, you just got done changing your oil filter.
It's like an outtake from a Ryan Nicholson movie.
Yeah, it's gross. And then also while I was watching this, the wife was like reading a newspaper or something next to me. She just looks up and she says, "Just when I think that the junk food dinner movies can't get any worse." And then she goes right back to the newspaper.
My wife straight up said this was worse than Nikudarama. That was her review.
Well,
I wouldn't go that far.
Yeah. I think this is a fine movie. I think that this movie is like, this is what cinema's for, is like this weird bullshit. Like, to make a singular, to keep using that word, a thing that no one else has ever made or will ever make. So in that way, I think this is a masterpiece, I guess, but I don't want to watch it. It's gross.
Yeah. And if you want to get serious with me and put together a Kickstarter to make a documentary to hunt these people down or to make an avant-garde off-Broadway play out of this, hit me up with some financial ideas and let's make this happen. But I think that wraps it up. For Bat Pussy from 1973, we are going to take a quick break. And when we come back, we are going to get into our next movie, and that is Cafe Flesh from 1982. So stick around.
You motherfucker.
Visiting the JFD video store. We hope you enjoyed our burning hot takes on this week's selected movie. Check us out on iTunes or junkfooddinner.com for full episodes. The audio version contains 3 full-length reviews per week, topical news segments, and listener feedback. Great for long commutes, exercise, or surviving the impending apocalypse. Thanks to Chuck Linnington for the on-screen artwork. Email jfdpodcast@gmail.com or check us out on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, Tumblr or whatever else is going on. We're probably there and wanna hear from you. Until next time, keep washing them dishes.
Next thing you know, he's boning this chick.